You sure? Yeah, it looks like you should be able to hear me. I need a new headset. Anyways. Literally just farting.
Sweet dreams, mate.
Time for your morning bath, my lord.
At this rate, I don't think he's going to last much longer.
Why can't I wear shoes?
Come on now, just a few more steps. Yeah, not so hard, was it?
Here we go again. You about ready?
These things take time. Put him back in. Why, you little shit!
What an electric chair. Are you kidding me? Oh, that's just like... So uniform. Do they have a gun or something? No. Can't. That's not my fun. Thing either. Ooh, can't get a fire. Ooh, that's...
Ah.
a little empty shell right there. Ooh, they pulled out. Ooh, the wrench has blood all over it. Grab something? He didn't, it didn't show that he grabbed something. What did he grab? What did he grab anything? Oh, he grabbed a gun. Okay. I thought he set it back down because there was no bullet. I love you, Molly.
Hands up.
All right, mates.
Not a word. Inside. Close them.
Let's just talk this through, shall we? You're him, aren't you? The convict everyone's talking about. There's only one way out of here. Walking Dead, that's what you are. Gonna wish you never left those catacombs.
Such a mouth.
Fair enough. Fair enough, it's your funeral, not mine.
Ah.
Give yourself up, monsieur. My next shot will not be a warning.
Surrender yourself!
Raise your hands, now!
Raise your hands!
Hands up!
Gray?
Don't do this!
I said surrender!
Hands on your head!
Galahad!
What are they supposed to do?
Raise your hands!
Hands up!
Gray?
Don't do this!
I said surrender!
Hands on your head!
You have betrayed our order! No one may escape the penalty!
You forget, Lord Chancellor. I'm as good as dead already.
Galahad!
I think of like, what is it, Cold Case?
Yeah.
Where it goes, da-da.
Galahad, come in. Galahad, acknowledge. This is command.
I read you, Percival.
Enjoying a stroll in the park, are we?
Nothing quite like a chilly London morning to stimulate the senses.
Not to interrupt your little constitutional, but we have confirmation of multiple marks of Grosvenor Square.
What are our directives?
Rendezvous at the United India House with Igraine and Lafayette and contain the threat. Do you have it in sight?
Right in front of me.
Thank you. On what day? What day is it?
The 30th, Tuesday. Tuesday at 5 o'clock.
Tuesday at 5 o'clock?
But it has to be early.
Okay.
Because this is Curtis class and I know. I can't leave until about 7 o'clock.
Tuesday at what time?
Tuesday at 5 o'clock.
Tuesday at 5 o'clock, okay.
And then you guys will go to the library at 6 o'clock because we have to do a second show for the other two classes' parents.
I've got to take Sarah at 4:30, I do believe, because she works on Tuesdays. So I'll drive my car over.
Okay.
All right,
okay.
Taylor, it's on the table.
Get it now. Raina says that she's
Tuesday.
I might have to drive back and drive to North Mesa because I've got to take Sarah. She works at 4:30 on Tuesdays.
Okay, but she's got to be there at 4:45.
Yeah.
Her performance is at 5 and at 6, but ours, we can watch it at 5.
Okay.
Because there's so many students in fifth grade, they had to split it into two performances.
Yeah.
So two teachers' classes can watch at 5 o'clock, which is ours.
Uh-huh.
And then two can watch at 6 o'clock, so she can't leave until after the 6 o'clock performance.
Well,
of course.
So after you guys watch the show, you guys can go in the library and wait for her. And then, you guys can come home.
Okay.
But she has to be there at 5.
All
so
right.
If you have to take her at 4:30, that's fine, because you got to take her at 4:30, which means you'll still be able to make it by 5.
Yeah, I'll be able to make it by 5, definitely.
So that means I'm going to be eating when I get home.
Yeah.
I'm going to be eating to pull through.
Yeah.
Good.
Sorry about
assess
that.
Assess the situation.
Pull through the performance if I eat.
Yes.
On there and proceed with caution. Did Nicola provide you with armament?
Yes. Mm-hmm. SXM-2 Falchion.
And fall right over.
Yes.
That would not be good.
No, it would not.
I'm hungry, I get very lazy.
Good. The Falchion's secondary ordnance should help.
Wow.
We may be pursuing bedlamites, but they remain civilians. Use non-lethal force whenever possible.
Understood. Are you joining us?
I have a small matter to attend to. I'll find you afterwards.
En route now. Galad out. Mm-hmm.
Oh, crap. Whatever. Kind of a pretty view. Really nice detail and everything. I wonder if I'll get the right horse. I think he cleaned it up better though. Where's his eyebrows though? Oh, no, I see it on this side. Oh, it's because he has a scar. Mm-hmm. What are those called? Mutton chops? No, not mutton chops. I guess we'll just go. About that doll. Oh, look at this little dude over here. Look at him. He's kind of cute. Can I crouch? No. I can't do anything. Tobias. Whoa. Hey there. How you doing? Yeah, Thank you. I like this picture. I like oil paintings. Look at the detail, though. Look, he has no reflection. This is the wallpaper. Is that a white switch? Oh, it's just turned away. Okay. Oh,
morning.
Butler, cleaning. Ooh, good. Newspaper. Deputy Coroner was open and inquired. Inspector Stafford was in the sound in Whitechapel last Tuesday incident. The T3 incident with four stab wounds in her abdomen and bruising on her throat. On the abdomen. The abdomen stated deceased was lying on her side when discovered. On this thing to drinking. Collapsed outside. After seeing the blood on her clothes, I haven't tried to wake her. One of these daggers. Unfortunate, she pronounced the unfortunate creature deceased shortly after arriving. They just called this woman a creature. After inquiries, some patrons at the tavern reported hearing or seeing such sturdy assault. The dead woman has yet to be named with none. Reported missing. I wonder if these are just collectibles, or if we're supposed to see, like, this is part of the case, or whatever he's gonna be going through. One of the local believers in the Parliament Streets likely has a room in common lodging houses. My parents' nourishment support this supposition, which could also explain the curious unwillingness of anyone step forward to identify the deceased. Miss Suzanne Peters, murdered a fortnight ago, also lived in a common lodging in Whitechapel and suffered stab wounds in the abdomen and mutilated her throat. Inhabited the streets and had been arrested previously for soliciting suitors. Oh. She's been named Spiders, frequently drunk. Dang. Walking towards her home with a gentleman. precisely the case of unknown investigators who found out their home, face down, clothing torn. Jeez. Robin, like, aftermath of the encounter that has altercation resulted from her visitor's refusal to pay her for her services. Cool. Wrote in which Miss Peter described as throat and stabbed in the stomach twice, killing her. And Reacher's tragic, and at the same time, Memphis pushes them to do its criminals. Clients comment as they endeavor to discover the identity of the perpetrator or perpetrators. Oh, it might be more than one. Okay. Ooh. I have a feeling I was supposed to read that. Ooh, good thing I did. Look at that. Look how pretty that is. Ooh. Remember the thing for you, please? The picture? Oh, it's a picture. G. Windham family, 20th July, 1886. Hey, that's the year that's in the name. W. Thompson, Porcher's family. It's a nice little family. Why wouldn't they smile, though? The Jones are like, take off the gloves. They've all gotten the mustaches, too. One, two, three, four, five. Two, three, four, five. Oh, okay. I was like, do they outnumber each other? Like a group, maybe? Are you in a family? There's these. Ooh, nice. Gotta enjoy the artwork. Ooh, hey. Hi. How are you?
Good day, sir.
Good day. Good day, sir. Oh, look. Is that a mule? I think it's a mule. That's pretty good. Is that an elephant over there? It's an elephant! Taylor! That's cool. I want to take pictures. Oh, I took a picture. I forgot. Oh, I figured it out. Okay. Should we name him? We're gonna name him Jade. He's like a jade green. Jade is green, yeah. Like a jade elephant. That's crazy. Yeah, I already picked that picture up. I'm not supposed to go over here. I think it's over here. That's dangerous, but that's where we shave. I wonder if this is like his own house. Or if it's somebody else's. How's it going?
Third time this week. These damn things are unreliable.
It's elevators for you. Where am I supposed to go? I'm supposed to go and see somebody.
I'm on my way down to the street.
Acknowledge.
Radio speaker? Looks like he has a speaker. Or like a... Wait, what? Really? What? Okay. Do some... Oh, what's it called? Parkour. There we go. Parkour. Parkour. No, just slide down. Got it.
Galahad, the Grey. Any word from Lafayette?
Negative.
That's crazy.
Yes. He's probably off somewhere gallivanting. Being, well, himself.
I know your concerns, but trust me, he's a good lad.
Did you say so? In any case, I have no time to look for him. I'm assigning the last few constables to their posts.
Charles Dickens, Tale of Two Cities. Tale of Two Cities, The Golden Thread on Monday and Tuesday. The Luminous City, Marvelous Play. Greenery, Nibelung, Rheingold by Richard Wagner. Don't want to know what's in the back of that nut. I'm gonna go over there. Ooh, chocolate. Chocolate bonbon. Bonbon. Ooh, still one of those. Ooh, good thing. Still one for Jen. Yeah, they can open. They're probably empty. Ooh, I'm moving faster.
City's off limits to civilians currently.
Then send a constable there.
No, I cannot do that, sir.
Why not?
Can you at least tell me they're safe?
All I can say is that we've asked everyone to remain inside their homes.
So you've spoken with them?
Not directly.
Then how can you assure me they're safe? What if our daughter wanders outside? What are we to do then? Do you have any idea who my husband is?
It's all right.
I like the dress. Kind of like looking in the alley. So that he's looking back, he's about to have to meet somebody. Well, pal. Oops.
And I need to see them.
I do understand, ma'am. But that section of the city is off limits. I cannot do that, sir.
She's butchering a sausage maker. Ooh, that is unsanitary. Ooh, that was stinky. 4 pounds. Ooh, ham, beef. Ooh, somebody's dying over here. Ooh, what's going on? What did you do? What did you do? What are you talking about? She looks like so disappointed in me.
Sir.
Oh, no,
please. You need to stabilize your breathing. They're much better.
He seems to have trouble breathing.
No. Yes, Constable, that is clearly the case.
Perhaps he needs a glass of water.
This man does not need a drink, he has asthma.
Are you a doctor, ma'am?
No, but my father is. I've seen plenty of people struggle with his condition. Constable, this man needs medical attention.
Unfortunately, ma'am, all medical personnel are currently unavailable.
Why?
Boggle off.
Ooh, flash. spears. What, I can't sniff it over? Take an apple. Nope. Repair.
Alright, sir.
Hi there. I almost thought there was a snake on my hand with the back. Oh no, it's feathers.
He seems to have trouble breathing.
But why would they not tell us the reason behind the commotion?
I'm sure it's nothing to worry about, darling.
Well, I am worried.
The police are just trying to keep everyone safe.
Galahad! See, you arrive here so quickly.
Nope. Maybe in your room? Or by the washer?
I must admit, you do move fast for a man of your age.
The knight cares to be reminded of his decrepitude by a fair damsel.
My lord, this damsel would never be so callous as to do such a thing.
Sure is he. Would you ever?
Nice gun.
Who are the marks?
Bedlamites, running amok. Percival thinks it could be a rebel subterfuge. Let's hope you haven't lost your edge.
Remember who trained you?
He was the best. In his day.
Was.
You're still pretty good. But I'm better.
Oh, really?
Yes, ma'am.
Igraine, come in.
Acknowledge, Percival.
Multiple escapees spotted at the east entrance of the United India Underground Station. Intercept with caution.
Understood. Come on, Gray. Let's move.
Are you serious? I didn't even know she was outside. I didn't close the door, though. Oh, okay.
Someone could give us more information on what is really happening.
Once we're inside, don't let anyone else through.
Sure you don't need help, love?
Do you mean a strong man to take control of things?
That's right.
Just stay out of our way. I'd hate for you to get shot by mistake.
Trouble?
The usual trigger-happy mercenaries.
The United India Company prefers its minions enthusiastic.
The last thing we need is a band of hired guns causing more havoc. I've told them to remain on lockdown. Take cover!
Come on!
Let's get to work.
Some weapons. You two, get your asses over here. I need help. Come on.
Go.
Let's go, you bloody bastards.
A rifle would be more appropriate.
Escaping down.
Oh, there's
more escapees coming from the alley.
Let's get out.
Some are heading for the atrium.
Shit.
The boat's coming at us!
Enemy down.
Street clear. There are more in the courtyard.
It's on the stairs. There. Escapee neutralized.
Lock the door. I can hear more commotion inside. Hurry. More bedlamites inside.
Slaughtering them. Ready?
Let's get rid of this scum. Smoke grenades.
Right. Enemy down.
In the bar.
Damn.
Escapee down! JP neutralized.
Shit. There were more on the level above. We need to get up there.
Got it.
We should clear the second floor. Everything to your liking, thus far?
Quite. Just another ordinary London morning.
Indeed.
Although I do hope that was only the beginning.
Ooh.
Ladies first.
Quiet.
You think we'll get to shoot a few of them rich folk? Huh? Say no more. I'll take that as a yes.
Target down.
Room clear.
You two.
Sir.
Downstairs. There are civilians who need your assistance.
Yes, sir. Sir, General Lafayette is in the next room.
You're joking. Is there a single woman in this city he won't try to seduce? Well, he's your problem now. Do try not to lag behind.
Lafayette.
Ah, monsieur. This lady requires my attention.
Marquis. Your attention is required elsewhere.
I assure you, mademoiselle, that only the vow of fidelity prevents me from accepting your invitation.
No, Marquis, you mustn't leave now.
Unfortunately, my lady, my duty compels me elsewhere.
Most fetching, was she not?
I hadn't noticed.
That is because you are not a Frenchman.
You are the most American Frenchman I have ever known.
I am a lover of liberty, mon ami.
A proper knight must learn to curb his passions.
Without passion, monsieur, a man cannot fight.
We do not fight men, Marquis.
Men, half-breeds, what does it matter? Vive la liberté!
Most American Frenchman.
Percival. Strange. Let's go.
It's about time.
Marquis, you and Lady Grain take that entrance. I'll go through this one and sweep for any remaining escapees.
Oui, monsieur.
Sir.
To all knights in the vicinity of Mayfair. The Metropolitan Police has finished cordoning off the affected areas. Sentinels are continuing their overhead sweep. We will alert you to any sightings of the escaped patients.
Acknowledge. Headway.
I'm in the generator room.
Lafayette and I have decided to split our search.
Oui, mademoiselle. But I have not met any resistance yet.
I'd beat you here. Remember, youth always prevails.
Oh,
Monsieur!
What happened?
I slew most of them. The last one got away. Grain, I need your op gun. I'll head up to street level and keep after him. You two go that way and head him off.
Understood.
Everyone all right?
Yes.
Percival, we've neutralized the threat on our side.
Good. I managed to capture one of the half-breeds. Rendezvous back at Regent Street.
Acknowledge. Let's go.
What should we do with him?
Westminster to the catacombs. We'll deal with him later.
Ah, Sir Percival. I thought the Order of Her Majesty's Royal Knights might be mixed up in this affray.
We had reason to suspect a rebel incursion, Commissioner.
An elementary conjecture. In that event, perhaps this might be of interest.
Whitechapel.
Purely circumstantial, of course.
I call it evidence.
Well, circumstantial evidence can be a tricky animal. My dear Sir Percival, you may think it is pointing at one thing, but shift your point of view slightly, and you may find it pointing in an equally uncompromising manner at something entirely different.
Please, indulge me with your musings, Commissioner.
Well, first the rebellion, and then this Jack and the Ripper murders.
Mm-hmm.
And then this. Strange, don't you think, that Whitechapel has become the epicenter of our recent conundrums? We must examine every clue now, you see?
We meet in council 2 days hence. If you would do us the honor of presenting your findings.
You can expect me at Westminster.
Over here, sir.
Do excuse me.
Where have you been? Bloody London traffic.
Mon General, what of the other half-breeds that escaped through Hyde Park? We must pursue them.
No.
Mais notre devoir est de les poursuivre, monsieur.
Marquis. Ne nous chassons pas des Anglais sur le nouveau continent. Votre témérité sera requis à un moment opportun.
Come on. Hold on. Be right back. I'm gonna grab something to drink. got a banana too.
Oui, mon général. I will be governed by your advice.
I'm sure you will appreciate that for the time being, this must remain a police matter.
Of course.
Something's amiss. The Underworld in Whitechapel is known to give safe harbor to the Rebellion.
That's precisely what troubles me.
Why would so many half-breeds be found in Bedlam?
Some things we need to find out for ourselves.
You heard, Commissioner Doyle. It's a police investigation now.
Knights do not relinquish their authority to bureaucrats.
Percival is right. This matter should be brought before the Council.
Centuries have passed. But our order has remained steadfast in its sacred mission to preserve the balance between man and half-breed. Such was the quest of our founder, King Arthur. May his name be forever resplendent!
Is it true? Did the Lord Chancellor fight by Arthur's side?
That is the legend.
Today, that balance is threatened with grave upset by a new contagion, the Rebellion. As long as its campaign of anarchy and terror is allowed to continue, the plague of lichen infestation that has infected our city will only grow more intolerable.
Well, the Lord Chancellor will thus agree to the urgency of a mission into Whitechapel.
Whitechapel is a matter for the civil authorities.
When the noble Arthur sought to contest for Truage with the Roman Emperor Lucius, he did not trouble himself with issues of jurisdiction.
Do not presume to quote history to me, Sir Percival. I've seen more of history than you shall ever know. I remind the knights here assembled that the threat to this order comes not only from without, but within. We must stand vigilant together, lest our ranks be poisoned by those who seek the destruction of all we hold sacred. No one is immune from the rebels' influence.
Surely the Lord Chancellor does not mean to question Sir Percival's loyalty.
This order has long appreciated Sir Percival's counsel, but the current disruption calls for caution and concerted effort, not rash action.
Sir Percival has cause, Lord Chancellor. The situation in Whitechapel may need to be addressed.
Does Lord Darwin speak with the blessing of the peers? Lord Hastings, Lord Dunglass.
He does. Lord Chancellor, perhaps the question should be put to the Council.
Very well. What says the Order of Her Majesty's Royal Knights in the matter of Whitechapel? Aye or nay?
Nay.
The nays have it. This Council is dismissed.
Our order grows too prudent, Grayson. We wither away from this inaction.
Leave it, Sebastian.
Caution be damned.
Sir Percival is most agitated.
You should learn it is best not to cross him when his mind is set on something.
What do you make of this?
Percival seems intent on pursuing his investigation.
You heard the Lord Chancellor. The Council will not stand for it.
Our brother Knight has made a habit of contravening his orders lately.
I fear many grow weary of Brother Percival's insubordination.
If anyone has the liberty to challenge the Council's authority, it is he.
We may have seldom few options left at this juncture. Do you believe the evidence enough to warrant our involvement?
We have worked with less than that in the past. But we haven't always been in the right.
What are we to do?
While half-breeds roam our streets. You cannot deny that there is some truth to what Percival has said.
Need I remind you of your place, Lady Egwene? Who are you to question the Council's wisdom?
Yes, Lord Chancellor.
Damn.
Galahad will deal with this in due time. I have a more pressing matter to attend.
As you wish.
How many of us will make the journey to America?
Lord Barrett, Lord Darwin, and myself.
I've heard many great things about the Agamemnon, Lord Hastings.
She is the finest the United India Company has ever built. I can promise you a pleasant and speedy journey across the Atlantic.
Can we expect your presence at the launch, Sir Lucan?
It would be my honor to see you off on your maiden voyage, my lords.
Sir Lucan, if I may.
If you'd permit me, my lords.
Of course, Sir Percival.
Alistair, you know as well as I do that Whitechapel is the key to these disturbances, to everything.
My opinion is immaterial. The Council has spoken.
Few dared countermand your father's express wishes.
Need I remind you that we all serve at the Lord Chancellor's pleasure?
You are the Knight Commander! Make him see reason.
You think an incursion into a rebel stronghold is reasonable?
I consider it an acceptable risk.
One for which you'd be willing to accept full responsibility should unforeseen circumstances arise.
Let what befalls be upon my head, no one else's.
Whitechapel remains off limits. That is, officially.
You have my thanks, Sir Lucan.
Of your thanks, I have no need. Bring me results.
As the Knight Commander wishes.
Jeez.
Well?
We're going in.
Most excellent.
When do we move?
You're not talking about Whitechapel. But my
Your brother sought fit to permit us a reconnaissance. Secure the necessary materials. Isabeau, a word.
Tell me, monsieur. About the Lord Chancellor.
What is a Marquis?
Sir Lucan and Lady Egwene were adopted by him, yes?
Yes, they were.
Why would he bring them into such struggle?
Perhaps he wanted to regain a semblance of the humanity he lost. When time came to join the Order, the choice was theirs to make.
Regardless, I would not wish this life on my children.
Marquis, we need to hurry.
Oui, mon général. Avec plaisir. Monsieur.
Friend Mallory has always been something of a rogue operative. I've never known a better man. Still, I shall rely on you to be a... call it a sobering influence. Sebastian and I have long been partners. I trust him with my life. A little restraint would not be ill-advised. Do look after my sister, won't you? No man in the realm can keep Isabeau from danger when she's of a mind. Well, you say true. What's a brother to do, eh? Good luck and Godspeed.
Always at your service, Sir Galahad. This way, please.
Ah, Tesla. Just the man.
Excuse me again.
What new developments do you have to show me?
Quite a few intriguing things, if I may say so. Further news of the trouble in Grosvenor Square?
Police are investigating. And investigating.
Lycans, on the United India Company's front doorstep. What do you make of it?
Mayfair isn't what it used to be.
Permit me to oversee a few of my new experiments. In the meanwhile, take a look around. Play with whatever strikes your fancy. But do be careful.
This is crazy. This is
Nicola, how fares your friend Edison these days?
Thomas and I are not on speaking terms. The man is an idiot!
Quite an antique. Hard to believe we ever use these communicators. All gibberish to me. Nicola, you sly dog.
Sir Galahad.
She's ready to go downstairs real quick. Are you ready to go downstairs and see them? She keeps asking what she has. Yeah, she has it. Come on, little girl.
Sir Galahad. Sir Galahad. Please, this way. Here is something you may find interesting. This device allows you to convert between Edison's inefficient direct current and my superior alternating current. Quite handy for overloading and incapacitating certain electrical systems. It's comprised of an inverter, transformer, and rectifier outfitted with some brass clips to enhance the design. Oh, and a fine leather carrying case. Inside each tube is a small quantity of mercury. When the mercury is properly aligned, the device becomes operational. Please, try it.
Pretty cool.
Ah.
You never cease to amaze, Nicola.
I'd appreciate your expert opinion on my latest whimsy. Here.
SX-84 Marksman carbine. Impressive.
You've always had a good eye for craftsmanship. I've outfitted this one with a telescopic sight. It's ideal for long-range shooting. I would be honored if you would test its efficacy.
With pleasure. The trigger pull is... Some muffling might be in order as well.
I'll attend to it immediately. So, are there any other of my children that you would like to meet?
The offer's tempting, but I must return to the others.
Of course. Oh, the monocular that General Lafayette requested is over there on the table.
I'll see that he gets it.
We scour the district in pairs. Isabeau, you and Lafayette take the high street from the south end. Galahad and I will move in from the north.
Why not give the Frenchman to Galahad?
Mademoiselle doubts my intentions. I promise to remain at all times the picture of chivalry.
I'd prefer to have someone more experienced looking out for me.
I thought you needed no looking after. Very well. You team with Galahad.
Mademoiselle will perhaps one day allow me to demonstrate my skill.
One day?
Remember, we are entering rebel territory. The insurgents will take umbrage at our incursion into Whitechapel.
Given our little discovery in Mayfair, the London hospital should be our target.
Strange to think Lycans would find sanctuary here, is it not, monsieur?
You really believe the rebels are collaborating with the half-breeds?
The Lord Chancellor is convinced of it. I have my doubts.
Do you trust anyone, mon général?
Never accept. Always question. It's a motto that's seen me through the centuries.
It's a good motto. Tomato. Not tomato with you.
Stay vigilant, all of you. We can expect hot work here.
Ah, quelle joie!
A nest of cut purses, collaborators, and whoremongers. I knew it very differently once. A lone chapel stood just there, offering sanctuary to travelers.
That was before even my time.
The city walls had yet to come up. Nothing is as it used to be, Sebastian.
True. The Order least of all.
We rendezvous at the hospital. Stay on your guard.
Understood.
This way, monsieur.
The ashes are still warm.
Oi.
That's it, Ken. Terry.
Come on, knock the stuffing out of him.
Ooh, you want more?
He's bleeding like a stuck pig, that one.
Doesn't look good. He ain't getting up. Stay down, you stupid git!
Must rise up, rise up and fight, reclaim their rights. They tell you things have never been better. They tell you England is making progress. What's all this progress brought you? Hideous slums, some no more than crannies of obscure misery. Long hours in factories, only to be paid a pittance and told by your master to be grateful for a few bob a week. Children worked to the bone in the black hell of coal mines while the captains of industry feast from silver bowls.
Who was the John?
I don't know. I swear.
You don't know.
I only got a
glimpse. She's dead because of you!
Bravo, monsieur.
Didn't care to dirty your aristocratic hands. It's all right. There's no need to be afraid.
How could I have known he was a Ripper? He was just another bloke.
He killed another one last night.
I didn't know.
Leave her be, monsieur.
I didn't know.
Don't worry. You're safe now. We should head through this door.
no weapons allowed in the establishment. You want to stay, you leave it here.
Bien sûr, monsieur. As a matter of fact, we were just looking for the coat closet.
Give it here. And a fun, governor.
At ease, monsieur. A quick reconnaissance of the premises seems imperative.
It's
your first time, isn't it?
Yes, Mum.
That's quite all right, love. We'll take this nice and slow.
All right.
Join me upstairs, love.
Another time.
I can show you things you've never seen before.
I don't doubt it.
That's fake. Noses too. Stupid bloke.
Don't get many Frenchmen around here. Why beat yourself? No, an officer.
Major General Lafayette, veteran of the American Army. At your service.
Marquis, this is no time for sport. We have to find a way out of here quickly.
I have just a thing, monsieur. If one of you ladies would reach into my pocket.
Give it here, love.
Is it sufficient, monsieur?
More than sufficient, I'd say.
Upstairs, then, if you please.
Ready, love. You won't forget this, I tell you. This way, love.
Get in here.
Oi! Here! What are you up to?
You're in the wrong room.
Where's the little frog gone?
He's in there!
With his friend.
Oi! Get out of there!
Hello?
We have intruders. Get your weapon. Let's go.
Lafayette. Shh.
Looks like we've stirred the nest. Keep a lookout, Marquis. I need to find a way through here.
I shall be diligent, monsieur.
sons and daughters of Britain. Be merry and joyful, for we have entered a new era of prosperity. Today, our glorious empire leads the relentless march of progress as Her Majesty's army and royal knights keep a watchful eye over our motherland, holding the half-breed threat at bay. The United India Company hoists our beloved Union Jack across the...
Let's keep our eyes open. Aye, two shorts for Bobby, one long for Knights.
Damn Knights. You sure it's not the other way around? Yeah. Two shorts for Knights and one long for Bobby.
Does it matter? Just keep your eyes open for either.
Well, I mean, if it's Knights, shouldn't we get some help?
Well, obviously, if we see any of those blackguards skulking around down there, we'll let the boys know.
And the same for Bobby's?
Nah, if it's just a few, we'll shoot them and be done.
And if it's more?
I don't know. We'll bloody shoot them too. Just shut your gob and keep looking.
I am on your side.
Clear.
Perhaps the rooftops are not our best path, monsieur.
You may be right. We need to find another way to the hospital.
Found a way out.
facile, hein? I sense that we are not welcome here.
Keep your eyes open. We don't want to create any further commotion.
Look, monsieur. God did not save this queen.
Move! Lafayette, keep your head down. We need to take out the sniper.
Absolument, monsieur.
Lafayette, take the street. Rebel down! We have to keep moving.
I imagine more rebels are on their way.
Hey, help me with the cops.
They've blocked the way. Through the building.
Courtyard.
targets down.
Understood, Marquis.
This is most exciting.
Oh, there.
What's your aim, Mazzola's first shot?
He's right here. I got him.
Coming out of the building. More rebels in the courtyard.
Throwing frag.
Reloading. Incoming.
No, that did some damage.
Enemy down! Rebel down.
Monsieur, I will fight them on the ground.
Understood,
Marquis. Keep them busy while I get the
man. Rebel neutralized.
You're all my knight.
To reload.
Monsieur, vous menacez.
I'm taking suppressing fire. Enemy down. Down.
Understood, Marquis.
I believe rebels are out of reinforcements, monsieur.
Shit.
We're almost through.
We need to keep moving and get off the streets.
A little help with the wagon, monsieur? A little help with the wagon, monsieur?
Percival. Percival, do you read me?
Save your breath, monsieur. The buildings are blocking the signal.
The curse of progress. Hand me your monocular. I can see our target. The hospital is 2 miles west.
Do you see our comrades?
Not yet. There. It must be them.
Shall we join the soiree?
Let's invite a few friends, shall we? Air Command, this is Galahad.
Sign off. 2 hours. I think it's about time. I do.